Hi gang, I'm glad you're all here. I really appreciate your time to watch my videos. At 2:08 a.m. this morning, March 2nd, 2022, there was a magnitude 3.4 earthquake near Joseph, Utah. 19 people said they felt this earthquake. It was one of the adjoining fault lines for the Wasatch Fault Zone that runs all the way up past Salt Lake City. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4, meaning during the day would have been felt by those inside, outside by a few. Would have woken some people up if they were sleeping. Dishes, windows, doors rattled. Walls made creaking sounds, sensation like a heavy truck striking a building. Standing automobiles rocked noticeably. Here on Utah.ed, it's got an image of all the earthquakes from 1850 to 2016. And I want to show you down here at the bottom the little fingers that I'm talking about of the different fault zones. Think of it like a tree and how the tree branches out under the ground. Or maybe, as a geologist there in Utah described, you got the main artery, which would be the fault zone up there by Salt Lake City. And then you have smaller vessels, blood streams that go off from the main arteries. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. 2017, there was a 3.4. And then in 2017, they had the largest earthquake recorded, a magnitude 5.7. This area is capable of having a magnitude 6 or greater earthquake. Yeah, hard to believe. Let's go back down to that earthquake. That even down here, they could have a magnitude 6 or greater earthquake. The area of this location, the fault zone, is buried. Yeah, they don't really have faults that are exposed along the ground. But they know they're there because of the earthquakes. Let's try and make that a little bit bigger. Yeah, you can't really see the names of the locations. And those are the earthquakes between 1850 and 2016. This map was made in 2017. And there's Salt Lake City. If you look at most documents about the Wasatch Fault Zone, they say the Wasatch goes as far as Fayette, Utah. But you can see here it actually extends farther. This is the location of the 3.4 and the one from 2017, the other 3.4. About 46 miles from Fayette. Like I said, the fault zones in this location, they're buried and hard to discern exactly where they're at. Unless, of course, you're looking at the different earthquakes, historical earthquakes they've had all the way down there. And there's been a lot of them. Majority of the buildings built there in that area are unreinforced masonry. There's a lot of historical buildings that are also unreinforced masonry. So if there's another large earthquake, there would once again be lots of damage. Are you prepared for a large earthquake? Have you done things that would lessen your chances of being injured or damage to your property? Going to Google Earth, here you can see a lot of brick buildings. Wood structures would hold up better. Over here is either a church or a school. I don't know. This one here is a school. Yeah, and it's a brick building. This one here looks to be the fire department, also made of brick. And then across the street, we have a wood house and another one made of partially brick and wood. And there's the school down there. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.